So we've been asked some more questions through our website, purelyprabhupada.com. The first one for this session is a simple question. What is real unity? So people are trying to find unity under different flags, sexual orientation, political party affiliation, skin color, so on. These ways of trying to find unity only result in further divisiveness, as it's simply creating more camps. There can't be any real unity until we accept that we're all siblings under God, not just the humans, but the animals, the birds, the fish, the plants, that we're all siblings under the loving protection of the Supreme Father. We're all looking for unity, but until we have at least an intellectual understanding of our real nature, our real position, there can only be disunity. Even the United Nations, there's no real unity. It's simply the creation of more and more flags as nations divide into smaller nations due to some experience of discontent. So until we accept our individual and collective position as sparks of the Supreme Lord, his offspring, there cannot be the harmony of real unity. Our next question was, how do we attract abundance and prosperity? Abundance and prosperity are possible only with localized sustainable agriculture based on cow protection and other principles of godly community living. We can't eat nuts, bolts, iPads, tires. We're currently living in a false economy with an artificial standard of life. It's not sustainable. It's not conducive to the development of Krishna consciousness, and it's doomed to fail. I could ask you also to please refer to the introductory series of videos that we did for purelyprabhupada.com. We have one video that discusses God-conscious community development and another video on cow protection, and I think your questions will be better answered through those videos. Our next question for this session is, what is sin, and how do I become free of sin? Sin means to act in a way that impedes our spiritual progress or the spiritual progress of others. Sin means to disobey the laws of God. In this age of Kali, there's special mercy in that we don't have to accept sinful reaction for evil thoughts that may come in the mind, but we have to be very careful not to let these thoughts translate into evil words or, worse yet, sinful actions. The mind and the speaking power must be controlled by hearing and chanting the Hare Krishna mantra and other topics of Krishna always. And the body must be engaged in acts of pure devotional service under the guidance of the bona fide spiritual master. Then there's no question of sinful activity. The literatures given by Srila Prabhupada describe this process in full. Our final question for this segment, a very wonderful question, actually. You talk of surrender to Krishna. The word surrender has a negative connotation for me. What does it mean to surrender to Krishna? To surrender to Krishna means to align our free will with the will of the Lord. It's not like holding up a white flag and surrendering to an enemy army, giving up your freedom, becoming a prisoner of war against your will. To align with the will of the Lord gives ever-increasing pleasure to both the Supreme Lord and to that person who aligns his or her free will with the Lord, surrendering to Krishna. It's a reuniting in bliss. It's a joyful homecoming. People talk about wholeness, surrendering to Krishna, aligning our free will with the will of the Lord is the perfection of wholeness and purpose.
If you are interested in the subject matter of this video and would like to learn more, please visit purelyprabhupada.com. Ancient Truths for the Upliftment of the Modern World.